Let's talk about what it means for a sequence to be bounded, and then how monotonic and bounded sequences end up being convergent. So a sequence is bounded if there are numbers for which the sequence terms travel only between those two numbers, so bounded by the two numbers. If the sequence converges, that means for some n beyond a certain capital M, they approach some limit. So if we pick the epsilon to be 1, then at some point all the sequence terms are going to be within 1 of the limit. So your bounds in that case are L minus 1 and L plus 1. So anytime you have a convergent sequence, it'll be bounded by just what the meaning of limit means. So convergent implies bounded. But bounded just by itself doesn't mean that the sequence is going to converge. So does not imply convergence. And then a simple example is the toggle switch of negative 1 to the n produces negative 1, 1, negative 1, 1 forever. It's bounded above by 2, for example, or 3 or any number, and below by 0, for example. So it's bounded, but it diverges because it has no limit. But if we add in monotonic, then we do get some results. So a sequence is called monotone or monotonic if it is either increasing, which means that the next term is always larger than the previous for all n, or if it's decreasing, which means that the next term is less than the one before it for all n. For example, 1/2 to the n is monotonic decreasing. The graph of y equals 1/2 to the x, which is sort of the general equation, because for the sequence terms themselves, you can just put these integer values in there like this and then get specific values. But you can see that every successive value is less than the one preceding it, so it's definitely monotonic and happens to be decreasing. And here's the math for that that you can look at. You know, every term gets less than the one before it. So here's a big theorem. If a sequence is bounded and monotonic, then it converges. So it's not enough just to be bounded, and it's not enough for it just to be monotone or monotonic. It has to be both of those. If it is both of those, bounded and monotonic or monotone, then it will converge. So bounded and monotonic implies convergent. So for example, the classic case of a person walking toward a wall. They start off 2 feet away from the wall, and each step they take is half the distance to the wall. So on the first step, they've gone 1 foot. On the second step, they go a half a foot, which is half the way to the wall. So the total distance they've gone is 3/2 feet. So if you make a sequence out of that by naming in the number of the step towards the wall they've taken, and the sequence then, which is the distance traveled going toward the wall when you're going one half the distance each step, we will show later with a geometric, what's called geometric series, that these are the terms then. 1 minus a half to the n divided by 1 minus a half, starting with n greater than or equal to 1. So for example, your first step, you have gone 1 foot by doing this calculation. Your second step, by doing the calculations over here, sure enough, it ends up that you've gone 3 halves. Next step, third step you take, you've now gone 7/4. And if you put the sequence into Wolfram Alpha, you find out on the fourth step, you've gone 15/8 feet. On the fifth step, 31/16. So since you started 2 feet away, you're never going to walk through the wall. You're going to be bounded by 2 feet for sure. So the sequence terms are bounded by 0 and below and 2 above. And Sn's monotonic and it's increasing. Every term is greater than the previous, like this. So it's increasing, monotonic, and it's bounded, therefore it converges. In fact, you can guess, as you're walking toward that wall, you're going to go 2 feet in the limit. You're never going to actually get to the wall, but in the limit, you will have traveled 2 feet. And you can see that mathematically by setting up the limit. As n goes to infinity, this term here goes to 0. So this approaches 1 over a half, which is 2.